So it's the night before my treatment, and most of you probably don't know that I have a rather large birthmark called a port wine stain that covers my face from here all the way down. It's about right here on my chest, a little bit in my ear, and a little bit on this side. You probably just think I'm like really blushing on one side, or I have like a sunburn in the summer, but that would be a port wine stain. A port wine stain is a vascular birthmark consisting of superficial and deeply dilated capillaries in the skin, which produce a reddish to purplish discoloration of the skin. It's part of the family of disorders known as vascular malformations. In English, that means my face would be a pretty dark purpley color if I didn't get the treatment and would look a little something like this. I've been getting these surgeries since I was 14 months old. About every 2 months since my first treatment, I've been getting them until middle school, when I started getting them less and less because I didn't want to go to school being purple because just the looks I got and all that. When I was younger, it didn't really matter because kids didn't care, but when you got older, the kids started to care, and I get a little more self-conscious about it and can't really put makeup on it, so it's going to school with purple all over my face, people. This was when I was about 18 months old. Usually I got 10 zaps, but obviously I had a little more than that. A lot of people ask me about how I feel about the treatment, and usually the day before, like now, I've been pretty moody, not exactly the happiest that I usually am. But then at the same time, I have to think about how thankful I am that this treatment even exists and that it helps me only be like that once in a while, like 2 weeks of that or my whole life. So I have to put things in the bigger picture. But during the time, I just want to crawl in a hole and not come out. I don't want to see anybody. I don't want people looking at me. I feel disgusting. I don't like people looking at my face like that. All right, well, I'm off to bed. Tomorrow I'll take you through the step-by-step process of getting ready and talk to Dr. Oster, who's been there every step of the way, except for the first couple surgeries, and get to see firsthand. So, see you in the morning. Okay, good morning. This is a day. So it's, what, 6:50? Should have got this on earlier, but we were slacking. So this is the tools. Cling wrap, a must. The numbing cream, which I don't have much of, so I won't be numbing my whole face today, which is gonna be joyous for later. And tape. So, here we go. Put my hair up a little bit so I don't get all, you know. This is gonna be really cold and I hate it. A lot, but that's what you gotta do. So just put it on. This usually hurts the worst. Actually, my neck hurts really bad, but I don't have enough of that. So, living through the pain today. But I'll do my jawline, because that hurts too. This is the fun part. I start my transition into, as my parents called me, the purple people eater. Which wasn't very nice. I looked it up this morning and some of the pictures weren't very nice. But they didn't know. This is pretty much the hottest look. I wanted to go to prom like this. So this is the final product before we venture off. It's too dark to videotape our conversation in the car, which is usually me going like this to hide from cars, because it looks different. So, I'll see you at the building. Gotta go up the elevator. Good times. Get ready to get this show on the road. Alright, this is Dr. Oster, who has been taking care of me since I was, what?
I don't know. It's a little bit too long. I was a young guy then.
You're still young. What are you talking
about?
Yes. And I just wondered if you could explain what the laser does.
Well, first of all, we're treating a what's called a congenital hemangioma. This is an excess accumulation of little small capillaries. Nobody knows for sure why this happens. There's a lot of theories. but actually about 0.5% of the population will be born with one of these birthmarks. That means in Michigan there's about probably 40 or 50,000 people who have a congenital hemangioma. So what we try to do is fade or eliminate these little capillaries, obviously without burning the skin, and we have very special lasers that do this. These lasers are a certain color of light. In this particular case, it's a yellow light that is selectively absorbed by the red pigment in blood. So when we flash the laser on the patient with the birthmark, what it results in, these little capillaries will contract and eventually disappear, so you can get some fading of the birthmark. Unfortunately, sometimes the birthmark will come back, so it means that intermittently we may have to treat the patient down the line. But overall, it's been very effective and relatively safe. Incidence of scarring from the treatment is very negligible.
Has there been any like improvements in the treatment? Because I know I've had different lasers.
Well, the treatments first started in about the middle of 1980s, about 1985. Two very smart dermatologists at Harvard University developed the theory. And since that time, the last 25 years, it has been improved significantly. Every new machine model is better than the one before it. So we're able to treat people much more effectively and also reduce the discomfort that the patient has with the cooling tip that's been added to the machine. And also, the early machines used to cause very severe bruising for about 2 weeks afterwards, but we're able to reduce this to a great degree. So the treatment is not perfect, but it does improve every year, and hopefully at some point we'll actually have a 100% solution to it.
On my neck because I'm burning right now. And yeah. Cool. Okay, well, that was my laser. It's off to school I go. Bye. Over the next 2 weeks, it will slowly scab up and fade back to my original skin tone so I can look normal again. No more purple people eater for me. Well, I hope you learned something new while watching this about a big chunk of our society. See you later.
By the lane with my hands in my pocket, jingling a wish card.